Yeah, let me go across to my live guests who joined me tonight, and let me go across to first to Mr. Venugopal Dhoot. Mr. Dhoot, corporate honchos nowadays is almost said and not very complimentarily by the BJP, by the left. Why do you think there's become this huge divide between corporate India now almost and the opposition? What's your response to that, sir? And is this something you see as good for the India story?
Yeah, corporate India has given their view, and Deepak Parekh Ganguly committee has said, Associate has also said in the newspaper today that they support government decision because government is upset with the inflation and the prices can come down if the FDI in retail comes. FDI in retail around $5 billion will be coming, and if that will solve the foreign exchange problem. Apart from that, when a farmer sends his good for sale, around 30% is lost. 20% is wastage and 10% goes for the people who are in between as a commission.
Yes.
So, all these to be saved and go, it should go in the hands of the customer. That is what the best thing government can do. But,
yes,
today Parliament has said no. So, what we always say that customer is king. But always customer is king, customer is benefited. But in politics, for them, the voters are the king. And voters somehow not been convinced that it is useful for them.
So,
unless the people of India are convinced that it is useful for them, opposition has got right to say all these things, and the benefit of that will not be going to the customer.
So who speaks for the voter, who speaks for the customer, who speaks for the farmer? These are questions that, with so many multifarious voices on right now, it's impossible to answer them. Let me bring in Vandana Shiva here, because we've seen this whole issue of farmers being debated a lot, and the question of the government making the point that the farmers are the one who will be benefited the most. That's what industrialists have also made the point that, look, how can a farmer get four times less the price than what it's sold in Delhi? You're somebody who's worked close to the Indian farmers but opposed FDI. Now, is that a ideological opposition to any kind of FDI, or is this something you're going case by case to?
I'm a physicist. I do my sums. And there are a number of myths being spread, including by arguments reiterated by Mr. Dhoot. This is the industry newspaper, the Financial Times, and it says a consolidated retail sector will require a consolidated agricultural sector. This will mean millions of India's small farmers being displaced. Now, we've seen what opening up the seed sector and FDI and seed did. We've seen what globalization and the early phase of reform, which was supposed to give market access to our small farmers, has done. 250,000 farmers commit suicide. Our agrarian sector is in deep, deep distress. Wherever Walmart enters, it destroys the small farmers and creates these large-scale monoculture industrial farms. Secondly, all the studies are there, including ours. Before globalization and reform, the difference between wholesale price and retail price used to be a 9-to-10 ratio. After removal of quantitative restrictions, it became 5-to-10. And in the current inflation, as well as driven further by Walmart kind of retail chains, what you get is a 1-to-10. The farmer only gets 1-to-2%.
So your facts completely contradicting.
Yeah, because I look at systems. I work with farmers.
So look, you work with farmers. Mr. Dhoot works with customers. Where does the truth actually lie, Patrick French?
Let me just add one more arithmetic. How can it be that you can pay farmers more, get the customer a cheaper thing, and still make $100 billion in the Walmart empire? The arithmetic doesn't add up.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.